Okay, here we are. First eight lanes. Junior Girls Youth Top 10 Tournament, 20th Anniversary Edition. On the all-new synthetic, first eight lanes. Kelly Stevens up first. And with us today is Brandon Mill, helping to commentate the match. And this match is Junior Girls Kelly Stevens versus Robin Ganderton. And Brandon, both these girls are from the first state program. And a good shot by Kelly in the first. And Robin Ganderton, our tournament leader.
And the first shot of Robin. She's been pulling for 9 years, so she has plenty of experience, for sure.
And Robin, and 559 in Pike Creek, a 455 at Bolarama, and a 543 at First State for a 1557 total to lead the tournament, actually by 167 pins over second place. And a total of five girls competing in the junior girls division.
Within Robin's 9 years of bowling, she's won the Coca-Cola tournament. She'd won. Came in first place, won scholarship. And she's been bowling for 9 years because she thinks it's fun. Bowling is fun.
And she leads a 4-7 here in the second frame. She makes a spare. Kelly Stevens qualified second in the event. She had a 447 in Pike Creek, 477, and a 466, 1390. And she gets a strike in the stepladder finals coming up to this championship match. Jessica Cassetta, 121, to Bonnie McMahon's 160. In the second match, Jackie Gudzilak, 203, to Bonnie's 157. And another strike by Kelly. And in the semifinal match, Kelly Stevens, 190, over Jackie Gudzilak's 137, to get us here today.
And our third look at Robin on lane four.
And that ball did not come up. Went out, hit the oil, and stayed there. So this is the 20th anniversary of the Youth Top 10 tournament, starting way back 1980-81 season. Many bowlers, Brandon, have been in this competition. Some of the best bowlers in the state today started out bowling in this tournament.
And to be on TV and win a top 10 would be a good accomplishment. And Robin gets five out of the six pins that were standing. Gives her a 41 in the third frame, and she draws by nine pins. She's 13 years old and started bowling when she was four. And she's been bowling for 9 years, as I already said. And Bob Gronzowski has coached her for a few years.
We get our look at Kelly here in the fourth. She's working on a double.
looks like she made the same small mistake as Robin. There's a lot of oil on the outside, and if your ball gets too far out, it will not come back. Still up by 23 pins. She's looking to pick up to 1-2. And she does. Good shot.
And that's the fourth frame, which means break time. We'll be back with more after these messages. And we're back with competition. At First State Lanes, the Junior Girls Youth Top 10 Championship. One of the juniors who won this tournament a number of years ago, Trish Renshaw, just this season won the women's top 20 tournament. And Kelly misses the 5-7. These are 94 in the fifth. Robin Ganderton, 41 with a strike.
Which leaves Robin just 43 pins under, but there's still plenty of room to come back. Looks like Robin's having just a smallest problem adjusting to the lanes, which are very tight because First State's new synthetic lanes aren't really as easy as the old wood yet. Take a while just to adjust.
She makes her spare. Brandon, you just bowled a match recently on the new synthetic. Did you find the same kind of problem that these girls are having, getting the ball to pop consistently?
I had the slightest, smallest problem, the same, similar, yes, I'll say so, because I was playing just a little bit more and more of a direct shot, but pretty much the same for me.
And a 10-pin by Robin. She's at 80 through 5. Kelly 94 through 5.
We have a 5-pin game.
And she's going to miss that. And we have another look at Kelly Stevens. Kelly's 14. She got interested in bowling through her parents. She was placed second in the top 10. She won doubles 9-0-10. Bowling since she was 5. And she said, she bowls at First State, and so is Robin. And the first starters. Her biggest influence are her parents. They started me in bowling and made me a better bowler. She likes the competition, meeting new people and improving her bowling skills. Slight advantage in this tournament, Brandon, since she has bowled before on TV.
Bowling on TV really isn't as easy as it sounds, and she may have the slightest advantage because Robin may be just a little nervous bowling on TV, or maybe she's nervous just bowling in a tournament. But the smallest reasons, she could just have the slight disadvantage. Could be because of the new lanes that aren't as easy as I said already.
They really haven't been broken in yet, so it's not be that easy for a while, that's for sure. Robin found something there. She got herself a strike.
Dobbins down by 24 pins, going to the eighth frame on a strike, hoping to get a double.
Time. We'll be back right after this.
What is a hero? Are heroes born? Or are they made? In after-school programs, your kids will uncover hidden strengths, discover they have the power to change their future, and find the hero inside themselves. Let us know you want after-school programs in your area. Call 1-800-USA-LEARN. After-school programs, helping kids find the hero within.
And we're back with action. Stevens in the eighth. Strike.
Wow.
Good follow through on that.
Very good shot. Gives her a strike me frame, going to the ninth on a strike. She's up by 24 pins. She's very comfortable, just as long as she doesn't make any mistakes. Open up the door for Robin. This match.
And a double. Really well on her way to a commanding lead in the tournament at this point. Robin comes back to strike of her own.
Looks like this match is just about over with. Robin, or a strikeout.
She didn't pull that one out. 157 for Robin Gantt.
She may have forced Kelly to get a good
Kelly
mark.
Stevens is going to be our Junior Worlds champion for 2001.
And she's going to finish all in four. Nine count. She leaves the head pin.
Brandon, she got it.
All she had to do was just hit the head pin.
She has a good game. Spare here. She's got a chance for a 200 on TV.
And all she has to do is make the head pin.
She's got a good follow through.
Kelly said, I missed it once, but I'm not going to miss it twice.
182, she needs an 8 count. And with that 8 count, she can add a $100 scholarship.
This will be a learning experience for Robin, first time on TV. There have been worse matches, but she still gets respect.
And she got the 8.
She got the 8.
Got 200.
200 right on the die. And a good game for Kelly.
And that's it. 200 for Kelly Stevens. 157 for Robin Ganderton. And we'll be back with more right after this.